Hello everyone and welcome in the 18th lecture of our control system series. So in last few lectures we completed our Laplace transform of some basic signal. Now in today's lecture we will discuss the concept of poles and zeros, the definition of poles and zeros, and why the roots of numerators are called zeros. We will see this with an example, and also why the roots of denominators are called poles. We will see this with an example. So many of you must be knowing how to find poles and zeros, but why they are called poles and why they are called zeros, we will see in this lecture. So I would request you to watch the complete lecture in order to have a clear understanding on poles and zeros. So let us start with the first point, that is concepts of poles and zeros. The transfer function of a linear control system can be expressed as T of s. T of s is the transfer function and it is equal to k into s minus 1 into s minus 2 and so on till s minus n upon s minus a into s minus b and so on till s minus m. Now this transfer function is a polynomial and it is a form of numerator upon denominator. Now before finding the poles and zeros of this transfer function, let us understand the definition of poles and zeros. Poles and zeros are those complex or critical frequencies which makes the transfer function infinity or zero. So it is a very straightforward definition. So it says the poles makes the transfer function infinity and the zeros makes the transfer function equals to zero. Now before discussing more about this poles and zeros, let us find the poles and zeros of the given transfer function. We have already discussed the transfer function. We have it in the form of numerator upon denominator. Here k is known as the gain factor of transfer function. We will have a separate lecture on this gain factor of transfer function. In this section, we are only discussing about poles and zeros. So the roots of numerator are zeros of the transfer function. So in numerator, we have s minus 1, s minus 2, so on till s minus n. So the roots of numerator are the zeros of the transfer function. For example, we have s minus s1. You can substitute this to 0. We will get s is equals to s1. So we have a 0 whose value is s is equals to s1. Similarly, we have s minus s2. You can equate this to 0. You will get s is equals to s2. So we have s is equals to s1 as 0, s is equals to s2, another zeros, and so on till s minus sn is equals to 0. So the roots of numerators are the zeros of the transfer function. Similarly, the roots of denominators are poles of the transfer function. So in denominator, we have s minus sa into s minus sb and so on till s minus sm. You can simply substitute the denominator equal to 0. We will get s minus sa is equal to 0. You will get the pole s is equals to plus sa. So the pole is at plus SA. Similarly, you can say S minus SB is equal to 0. You will get the pole S is equals to plus SB. So this is the way how we have to find the poles and zeros from a transfer function. Now many of you must be knowing how to find the poles and zeros of the transfer function. As said, the roots of numerators are the zeros and the roots of denominator are the poles. But our next question is, why the roots of numerator are called zeros of a transfer function and the roots of denominators are called poles of a transfer function? So as I told you, many of you must be knowing what are the poles and zeros in a transfer function, but why they are called poles and zeros, this is a good question. Now to answer this question, let us take one example so that we can plot all the poles and zeros and also answer our question. So in the question, we have given a transfer function P of S is equals to 10 into S plus 2 upon S plus 3 into S plus 4. And we are told to plot the poles and zeros on the S plane. And also in the same question, we will discuss why the roots of numerator are the zeros of the transfer function and the roots of denominators are the poles of the transfer function in this example. So now let us find the solution for this question. Now in the question, they have mentioned to plot the poles and zeros on the S plane. Now first, let us discuss about this S plane. So this is a diagram of a S plane. On X axis, we have sigma. Since S is sigma plus j omega, on X axis, we plot the sigma. On Y axis, we plot j omega. So the S plane is a plot of sigma versus j omega. The detailed study of S plane you will study in the subject Signals and Systems in chapter Laplace Transform. So we know S is equals to sigma plus j omega, where the sigma represents the real part and j omega represents the imaginary part. Now first let us find the zeros. Now for zeros, the roots of numerator are the zeros. So in numerator I have s plus 2. So equate this s plus 2 to 0. You will get s is equals to minus 2. So this is the zeros of our transfer function. Similarly, for poles, we have to equate the denominator to 0. So we have s plus 3 equals to 0. So we have one pole. I can write this as s1 is equals to minus 3. And we have second pole, s plus 4. We can equate this to 0. So I have the second pole, s2, I can give the name s2, is equals to minus 4. So from this transfer function, I have 1, 0, s is equals to minus 2, and I have two poles, which is the first pole is s1, it is equals to minus 3, and second pole s2, it is equal to minus 4. In the next lecture, we will discuss the different types of poles and zeros. We have simple poles, complex poles, repetitive poles. So that everything we will discuss in the next lecture. So coming back to this question, so we have 1, 0, which is at minus 2, and 2 poles, which are at minus 3 and minus 4. Now we have to plot this zeros and poles on this S plane. So let us plot the poles and zeros of this transfer function. We have one pole, that is s is equals to minus 2, and we have two poles, that is s is equals to minus 3 and s is equals to minus 4. We have to plot this on the S plane. As we already discussed, that the S plane is the graph of sigma versus j omega. So first let us plot the first zero, which is at s is equals to minus 2. So a zero, you can draw a small zero. Since it is minus 2, it will be on left hand side. So we can represent the zero as a small zero and it is at minus 2. Then we will plot the poles. The first pole is at minus 3. A pole is plotted with a cross sign, and since it is minus 3, it will be also on the left hand side of the S plane. So S is equals to minus 3 is a pole. We have one more pole, S is equals to minus 4. So this is the way to plot the poles and zeros on the S plane. As I told you, in further lectures, we will discuss more about the complex poles in upcoming lectures. So we have plotted the poles and the zeros on the S plane. So let us come back to the question, why the roots of the numerators are called the zeros of the transfer function. So we have the transfer function. This is the same example, which is 10 into S plus 2 upon S plus 3 into S plus 4. And the zeros was at S is equals to minus 2. Now if you substitute the value of 0, which is S minus 2 in the transfer function, let us see what is the value of the transfer function. So T of S is equals to 10 into the value of S is minus 2, so it is minus 2 plus 2 upon S plus 3, the value of S is minus 2 plus 3 into minus 2 plus 4. So it will be 10 into minus 2 plus 2, it will be 0. Upon minus 2 plus 1, it will be 1. Into minus 2 plus 4, it will be 2. But the overall transfer function will be 0 because there is a 0 in the numerator. So we can say when you put the numerator roots in the transfer function becomes 0. Hence, the roots of numerator are called the zeros of the transfer function. So if you are asked in the Viva or in college exams why the roots of numerator are the zeros of the transfer function, now you can easily give the answer. Similarly, we can prove why the roots of denominators are called poles of the transfer function. Again, we have taken the same question. So we have the same transfer function. T of S is equals to 10 into S plus 2 upon S plus 3 into S plus 4. This 10 is nothing but the gain of transfer function. We will talk about the gain of the transfer function in our upcoming videos. Now we saw the poles of this transfer function are S is equals to minus 3 and S is equals to minus 4. Now we can substitute the value of poles, that is S is equals to minus 3 and S is equals to minus 4, in the transfer function. Let us see what answer we get. So T of S, let us first substitute S is equals to minus 3. So it will be 10 into S is minus 3 plus 2 upon S is minus 3 plus 3 into minus 3 plus 4. This will be equal to 10 into minus 1 upon 0 into 1. So anything upon 0 is infinity. So when we have put the value of the pole, that is S is equals to minus 3, the transfer function became infinite. So we can say when you put the denominator roots in transfer function, the transfer function becomes infinite. Hence, the roots of denominators are called the poles of transfer function. So this was a simple idea about poles and zeros. In the next lecture, we will discuss the types of poles and zeros. There are simple poles, there are complex poles, there are poles which coincide. So we will study them one by one. These are all important lectures which will clear your basics and you will have a good command in this subject. So in next lecture, we will discuss all these topics.